Africa is splitting into two at an alarming rate. Yeah, this is history happening right before our very eyes. Due to a giant fault line, Eastern Africa is breaking away from the rest of Africa. One thing that's worrying a lot of people is how quickly this divide is happening, as it could be dangerous for the people living there. Some have even been asked to evacuate their homes. The full separation isn't going to happen for quite some time, but geologists fear that this rift is already causing noticeable issues. For example, an extremely busy main road in Kenya has caved in. This collapse was caused by volcanic activity, and because of this, that cannot be prevented. This tear in the earth is estimated to be 50 feet deep and over 20 meters wide, and the fault line itself is said to stretch over 700 meters. About this split, geologist David Ahid said, "The Great Rift splits Africa into two plates. With what has happened, we have established one plate, which is the Somalian plate, is moving away from the other plate at a rate of 2.5 centimeters. There is a great need for researchers to conduct a comprehensive study on the terrain of this region so they can advise on where roads and residential buildings can be established. This is a pretty monumental thing that's happening." And we'll keep you guys up to date with the story. Hey guys, welcome back to LPM, Court McGinley. I hope you're all having a wonderful week so far. We've officially made it halfway through the week, and the weekend is right around the corner. I just want to remind you guys to stay tuned until the end of this video, as I'll be answering some of your questions and reading comments. If there's anything you want to know, then make sure you leave it down in the comments, and I might answer it in an upcoming video. Also, make sure you show some love by giving this video a big thumbs up. Alright, as you guys know, we have a lot of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Next, ISIS has claimed responsibility for Kabul suicide bombing that's killed 32 people. Earlier today, a suicide bomber blew himself up near a shrine in Kabul. A total of 32 people were killed and dozens more were wounded. This bombing took place during the celebration of the start of the Persian New Year. After the attack, ISIS claimed responsibility. Security was supposed to be at an all-time high after the attack in January that killed around 100 people. But this bomber was able to detonate his explosives as people were leaving the shrine in the west end of the city. It was said the bomber tried to go inside the shrine but was stopped from getting any closer by police checkpoints. So it was a good thing that the checkpoints were in place. Our thoughts go out to those who have lost loved ones during this attack, and we hope all the people who have been wounded and are in the hospital make a full recovery. Next, Austin bomber has been identified as Mark Anthony Condit. Before it being confirmed, Mark was a suspect in a wave of bombings that terrorized Austin. Earlier today, he killed himself with an explosive inside of his car after he noticed a SWAT team was approaching him. Investigators believe that he is the person responsible for the 5 explosions that killed 2 people and injured 5 others in Austin since March 2nd. In the last attack before Mark's death, a package exploded yesterday morning at a FedEx sorting center near San Antonio, and a second unexploded bomb was delivered just hours later at another FedEx near Austin. The police were able to accuse Mark thanks to camera footage from the facilities connected to Tuesday's incident. The police believe Mark was working alone, but they will still be cautious in case he did have accomplices. Next, Marvelland is coming to Disneyland by 2020. Yeah, I know, so many people are freaking out right now. This is super cool. This superhero themed area will take the spot of the current Bugs Land. The California park isn't going to be the only park assembling the Avengers. There will also be Marvel Lands hitting Hong Kong and Paris as well. And Paris is actually taking it one step further and will allow guests to team up with Iron Man and other Avengers as they go on an adventure. And then in Hong Kong, fans will be able to team up with Ant-Man and the Wasp on a new ride which will run alongside the Iron Man experience, which is already open at their park. This is all very exciting, but 2020 is kind of far away, so to tide yourselves over in the meantime, make sure you check out Marvel's Avengers Infinity War hitting theaters April 26th. Next, yesterday, Olympic power couple, even though they claim they aren't dating, Tessa Virtue and Scott Moir were on The Ellen Show. What's pretty cool is that fans of the Olympic duo actually campaigned to get them on the show. The two came on the show with their gold medals around their neck. They are actually now the most decorated figure skaters in history. During the interview, Ellen brings up the fact that they have been skating together for 20 years now, and that there's obvious chemistry, and then brings up the fact that everyone assumes the couple are dating. To which they said they are not, but they do view it as a big compliment, as they feel people are invested in their partnership and can see how much they trust one another and care for each other. Ellen then continues to pry, as she does, and eventually she gets Scott to admit they actually did date in the past. When they were 9, they would hold hands while skating, but they decided to put their careers first, so Scott had to end things with Tessa. But clearly that worked out for the best. And yeah, the truth finally comes out. Next, NSYNC are finally getting their star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. This boy band made up of Justin, Lance, Joey, JC, and Chris will be permanently cemented into Hollywood history on April 30th. And I love how they're getting it right before May. Very fitting. I'm kinda surprised they don't already have a star, but congratulations to them on this milestone. And it's that the time of the week where I answer your questions and read some comments, so let's get started. Zikra Hasnain, sorry if I said that wrong, asked, what kind of music do you listen to and who is your favorite artist? My favorite kind of music is country, top 40, 2000, and 90s music. And I have a few favorite artists, and some of them are Blake Shelton, Luke Bryan, Shania, Taylor Swift, Ariana Grande, Zach Brown Band, Hailee Steinfeld, and many, many more. Next, Stephen Battle asked, if you could have any pet, what would you have? Definitely a dog, but I also love foxes and elephants, so they would be pretty cool pets too. Next, Gerardo Badola asks, do you think teachers should have guns? Random question. See, that's a very touchy subject. I do think teachers should be trained in how to handle a gun and what to do in case of an attack. But do I think they should physically have them in their classrooms? Probably not. I only say that because there are so many studies that prove people who have guns in their homes more often than not have them used against them. And plus, if there's someone who's looking to use a gun, it's probably best that there is not one accessible to them and at their school. Next, Kahar Alam asks, do you have any weird habits? I always laugh at my own jokes. Like, I get into hysterics laughing because I just think I'm hilarious, apparently. Also, whenever I'm eating a sandwich or burger, I tend to pick off most of the bread. Like, any extra little bits of bread, I'll just pick off and leave it on the plate. Yeah, I'm odd. Finally, we have a question from Fear Lion Mouse, who asked, what do you think about conspiracy theories and what historic events interest you? For conspiracy theories, they really fascinate me, maybe like a little bit too much. I could spend hours watching conspiracy theory videos. And for historical events, I'm really into the Salem witch trials. I find that pretty interesting. In fact, last Halloween, my husband and I took a trip to Salem and we were able to learn more about the trials and see a witch's old house. It was pretty cool. Plus, we got to see the Hocus Pocus house. That was the highlight for me for sure. And there you guys have it. That's all the stories and questions I have for you today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see all of you tomorrow.